full-on Indo. Chino.
It's like a weight loss commercial.
6-1.
Time to wrap up the week. And yes, it's mail it in because it's our last show of the week. But it's different. Most people work Monday to Friday. They're like, ah, oh, Friday, here's the weekend.
Yeah.
But when you work with producer Tim, the last day of the week is like Christmas, your birthday, New Year's, all wrapped into one every single week.
That's right. We finally get a couple of days away from that guy.
Oh, man.
Oh, you're really stressed about it. We just started the show.
Okay. I'm over it. Hey, how about Patty Marlowe returning to the place he made a name for himself?
That's right, Dan. Sharks are still upset at Nazem Kadri, Dan, for pulling a chunk out of Joe Thornton's beard the last time they played. So Barkley Goodrow tried to get Kadri to fight. Instead, he puts the Leafs on the man advantage. And as that Leafs power play is expiring, John Tavares banks it in off Mark Edward Vlasic and extends his point streak to 8 games and opens the scoring for the Buzz. Erik Karlsson still has not scored as the San Jose Shark. Dumps it in. Freddie Anderson doesn't know where it is. And Kevin LeBanc. You know where you can take that one to. 4-on-4 now. Vander Kane with the turnover, and there is Patty Marlowe, the former Shark, to Kasperi Kapanen. That is Marlowe's first point against his former team. It's 2-1, Sharks power play. Erik Karlsson to Brent Burns. His shot would be deflected in by Sharks captain Joe Pavelski. He has 11 on the season. He's from the USA. We're tied at 2-2 to go to Puri. Pavelski to Vlasic. Freddie Anderson allows 3 goals in a game for the first time since October the 10th. Second period, Leafs 2-on-1. Tyler Ennis. How about this shot from Josh Levo? Levo. And so the Buds have tied it. And then soon after that, Mitch Marner causes a turnover. Kasperi Kapanen in alone. And he beats Martin Jones to make it 4-3. For your Toronto Maple Buds in the second.
Flames at home to the Habs over his last 5 games. Carey Price, 14 goals against average, over 4, and an .854 save percentage. One of them Habs in the first. Price makes the stop. Johnny Goudreau on the doorstep. Oh, he's dummy! Price, perfect through 20, stopped all 13 shots sent his way early in the second. Flames on the man advantage. Matthew Tkachuk, one-timer. Beats Price. Tkachuk's 8th of the season. Ties it at 1. Same period, TJ Brody. Goes around the net. Finds Tkachuk in front. Second of the period. Calgary outshot Montreal 32-17 after 40. Flames took a 1-goal lead in intermission. Third period, Mike Smith makes the initial save. Jonathan Drouin on the rebound. Max Domi picking up a helper, extends his point streak to 8 games. Montreal ties it at 2.
Oh, Mike Smith.
Weaker than a Vegas highball. Arturi Lehkonen gets his first goal since opening night. After the play, Michael Backlund comes over to the Habs bench, shoves Drouin. Andrew Shaw livid. Flames forward got 2 for unsportsmanlike conduct. James Neal. Stopped. Price denies Sam Benn on the rebound. Carey Price, 43 stops in his return to the creases. The Habs win on the road, 3-2.
Well, the Canucks are very happy to be wrapping up a 6-game road trip. They've lost 3 straight. They were in Minnesota. Early first, Jonas Brodin.
Wild break it up as the Canucks try to bring the puck
out of his own zone to Charlie Coyle. The Coiler, who beats Richard Bachman. You know, this could lead to the top 10 long-distance passes. On Friday, we did that this week. Never mind. Bachman, who is seeing his first NHL action since April of 2017, not helping himself here. The clearing attempt is right on Mikko Koivu's stick. That didn't work. That didn't work at all. 2 goals on 4 shots. And the Canucks are down 2-0 early. Travis Green Wonder if he spent some time at the Mall of America on Thursday. Elias Pettersson, no points in his last three games. Drops it for friend of SportsCenter with Jay and Dan, Michael Delzato, and he hits the post! Oh, so close for Delzato, a favorite of the crew. Little later, Bo Horvat.
Try to right side pass. Canucks get it back to Horvat.
Squeaker past Devan Dubnyk is 10th. Canucks are on the board, down 3-1, but still in the second. Eric Staal has his pass block, stays with it. Wrap around, it's in. Off Bachman and in. Oh, Bachman. That's his fifth for Staal. 4-1 Wild, early third. Jason Zucker will dump it in. Staal somehow gets to this, sends it back to Zucker, and he scores. Just a tough night all around for the Canucks. They have dropped four straight.
Lace, the road trip's finally over. Wings and Sens, 20-year-old Drake Batherson making his NHL debut. Should be taking the lonely rookie lap before this one. Two of his fellow rookie teammates did that earlier this year, but they forgot Zach Smith at first. Batherson, he's way back in the line. Bobby Ryan, he was mic'd up during warm-up and explained why.
You know, there's a little miscommunication because Zach Smith takes us out on the ice and he's wearing the cage. He's got that college crazy look in his eyes and he jumped the gun a little bit. So Bass's going to play about 1,000 more. We'll get him on the next go around.
There you go. And we know his nickname now, Bats. Just minutes into Bats' NHL career, falls in the crease, interfering with Jimmy Howard. Dylan DeMello scores. The goal initially counts. After review, it's ruled Batherson interfered with Howard. No goal. Now, the Sens had a goalie interference call go against them earlier this week, and Craig Anderson, his reaction, yeah, he's like, come on, guys, get it together. No one knows what the rule is. Final minute of the first, Matt Duchene fires, Cody Ceci scores, 1-0 Sens. During the intermission, Smith, who robbed Batherson of experience in the rookie lap, explained himself.
Well, it was my first game back in a while, so I wanted it, but he'll get one next game, that's for sure.
Bobby blamed you, is that fair?
No, that's not. I was the one that stopped, and he's the one that said kept going, so we got to straighten that rumor out.
Second period. Ord Miller on the call, first goal on his first shot, puts the Sens ahead. He's the first player in the third or fourth round of the 2017 draft to make their NHL debut. His parents in the crowd. His father, Norm, played pro hockey, played in the AHL, played in Germany.
Watch him readjust the puck right there. Put in the shoot.
Norm. Matt Duchene grabs the puck. Make sure Batherson's going to... Saltsy. Make sure Saltsy gets that souvenir.
I got cut off there. Producer Tim wants to call him Saltsy for bath salts. Get it, Tulsi?
Producer Tim, big bath salts guy. Huge third period from Anderson. Andreas Athanasiou sent it alone. CeCe grabs him. Athanasiou is awarded a penalty shot. Guy Boucher, what do you think of that?
Come on, what the?
Athanasiou. Guess Anderson. Stops. Sends. Still have that 2-1 lead. Just over 4 minutes to play. Chris Weidman's point shot block. Michael Rasmussen, he's on a break. And Weidman trips him, so yes, Wings give it another penalty shot. Their second penalty shot in under 7 minutes. So Anderson has to face Rasmussen, and another huge stop. Craig Anderson, phenomenal, 34 saves.
Good old Saltsy, eh, Toolsy?
Yeah.
He scored 2 points against Jersey on Tuesday, then Wednesday missed practice with a mysterious upper body injury. It wasn't supposed to be serious, but now Penn's head coach Mike Sullivan says Sidney Crosby will be out a week. Though he did point out Crosby is not dealing with a concussion. So that's good news. Bad news for the Lightning. No Andre Vasilevsky. He's out with a broken foot, so Louis Domingue getting the start against the Pens on Thursday.
Chris Letang.
Penguins power play. Evgeny Malkin stopped. Or was it Domingue? Or was it Ryan McDonagh? Yeah, it was McDonagh with the great arm stop. Here are these Penguins thirds. With the yellow helmets, the consensus seems to be the jerseys would be fine if they went with the black helmets. Phil Kessel and Gino Malkin both called for minor penalties on the same play. Then seconds into the Lightning power play, Matt Cullen takes another minor, joining Kessel and Malkin in the box. So A full 2 minute Murray five on three for the Bolts. Braden Point.
Drive, by Murray.
Will score. So the Pens lead has been cut to one, just 10 seconds into the man advantage. Still with the two man advantage to start the second. Steven Stamkos spots Point, and now we are tied at two. And then with Cullen still in the penalty box, the Bolts moving it around, and Point with his third goal in a minute 31.
Ah, that's why the timer was there. I was starting to wonder.
Yeah, yeah. That's all part of the stories we tell on this show, Dan. It's a natural hat trick, all in the power play. First hat trick of his career. Sixth fastest hat trick in National Hockey League history. And then it's Yanni Gord who combines the best name in Greece with the best name in Canada, beating Matt Murray. Pens have lost seven of their last eight. I mentioned Braden Point, three goals in the span of 91 seconds over the first and second periods. Sixth fastest in NHL history, all three on the power play. It's also a Tampa franchise record for the fastest three goals by a Lightning player. Well, this has been a real fun show so far.
Yeah. Really sweaty, though. We've tried to get the temperature adjusted, but it's a process.
Yeah, we have to call security, and then they have to approve it. There's a committee.
And then they have to call Laval.
So. Shout out to Laval. Was it Zdeno Chara, Dan?
Yeah, they sent him back to Boston to be reevaluated by team doctors. After suffering an apparent injury on Wednesday, 41-year-old's left leg bent awkwardly while checking the Avs' Carl Soderberg. Left the game, did not return. Chara, three goals, one assist in 18 games so far this season. And the guy's in his 21st NHL season. He's played over 1,400 games. He's going to get bumps and bruises. Let him get some rest.
Yeah, the Bruins, Charlie McAvoy, Brandon Carlo, Kevin Miller, Juho Vaakanainen, and all out. On the blue line for the Bees, so they need some blue line help. During pre- and post-game media availability, Dan, NHL dressing rooms can get pretty packed, and some reporters are forced into the background to get the best sound bites. You'll see it in this segment that everyone's talking about in the press box. It's NHL Scrub Lurkers.
Everyone's counting on in this room be a, you know, an impact player night in and night out.
Tom Green, second from the end.
Gary Lawless making another appearance in NHL Scrub Lurkers.
Still to come as an award-winning anchor and best-selling author. It's my honor to tell you that the Jennies are coming up next here on the Producer Tim Hour on TSN. Bowlers in the offseason. Lightning and Penguins begin our edition of the Jennies to finish off the week. Ryan McDonagh, this has got to be the highlight of the night, doesn't it? Sacrificing his body to make the save on Gino Malkin.
Alterie Gilbert steals.
This has got to be the worst play of the day, doesn't it, Dan? Richard Bachman tries to clear the puck and puts it right on the stick of Mikko Koivu.
Virginia forces a turnover, gets it up court. Justin Robinson off glass for Ahmed Hill, who throws it down. This gym could use about 30 to 40 more lights.
You're always very concerned about the lighting. Devil Flyers.
Hey,
Ryan Elliott.
I mentioned it this week on our podcast. I'm very big into lighting because I went to a restaurant. Lighting was horrible.
Yeah. Jesper Bratt. Of course, he directed Garden State.
And it's done.
Zach Braff.
All right, Zach Braff. You know, in hindsight, that movie was hot garbage.
That movie, but it spoke to me, man.
That movie was garbage.
Well lit,
though. Just terrible.
Well
lit. Yeah, good lighting, though, in the film. I understand.
Seriously, no one wants something that's...
Yeah, thank you. That's what I think about Garden State.
Good soundtrack.
Yeah, that's why everyone thought it was a good movie. And Natalie Portman. Can't go wrong with her. Hey, coming up, Dave Naylor joins us. Stay tuned. That's why Garden State is such a crap movie.
Hey, pretty big news from the CFL on Thursday. They announced that they're going to add an eighth official on the field for this weekend's division finals and the Grey Cup. The added official's only responsibility will be to watch for blows to the head or neck of the quarterback. Change comes after the head referee had his view blocked on a high hit to Brandon Bridge during the West semifinal and was not flagged. If the eighth official sees a hit that hasn't been penalized, they will advise the head ref, who can then assess a roughing the passer penalty. For more on the added official, we welcome in the nail gun, Dave Naylor. It was strange. Why would June Jones ever be upset about player safety? Anyway, well, another coach, he's all for it. Okay, so why did they go this route? Adding a ref on the field instead of maybe just using the command center?
I think there was a lot of conversation at the league office and with the teams about using the command center, because it seems like the most obvious way, right? The command center is used to correct other mistakes or errors already in the game. But I think there was concern about whether there would be delays. I think just in terms of getting up to speed and whether there would be any unforeseen growing pains in using this for an additional purpose. With three games left, it just seemed like putting an additional official on the field was the simplest, perhaps the most effective, and certainly the least disruptive of the options before them. And you know what they're calling the eighth official? The eighth official.
I just love the term command center. It's going to be a great game. Thanks for joining us, Dave.
My pleasure, guys. Enjoy them.
The Bombers are one win away from their first Grey Cup appearance in 7 years. And after a four-game losing streak earlier this season, Winnipeg has won six of their last seven going into Sunday. Matt Nichols threw 12 picks in those first eight games. Since then, it's thrown just one pick in his last six.
To me, it's not so much about proving people wrong. It's about proving the people around me right, and you know, that's what's more important to me. Obviously, we've been winning some games, but all that's for nothing if we don't do it again this week.
The billionaire strut.
The McGregor.
I love it. The Vince McMahon. I think, did Vince McMahon originate that? Because that his was the best. All right. Hey, Dan, this will be the first time the Bombers and Stamps have met in the playoffs since the 2011 Grey Cup. The game Calgary won is a heavy underdog. They'll be the favorites on Sunday. Bombers and Stamps at 4 Eastern. But before that, it is the Eastern Final between the Red Blacks and Jeremiah Masoli's Hamilton Tiger Cats. Hamilton's won 3 out of 3 games of the regular season between these two teams. Can they make it 4? Coverage begins Sunday at noon Eastern.
Carmelo Anthony and the Houston Rockets have parted ways. We all saw this coming. But they have no plans to immediately waive him, per league sources. Since joining the Rockets as a free agent in the offseason, Anthony's played just 10 regular season games with the team. So he's made how much in his career?
$245 million, something like that.
Yeah, just it's time.
No, he's got to keep playing. He got divorced from Lala Vasquez.
So is he going to L.A.?
Yeah, probably. Make a little more money. But it doesn't matter. He has no legacy to destroy.
It affects my life in no way. So
fair enough. Well, how about Mookie Betts getting the AL MVP? How do you like that one? He's the first Red Sox player since Dustin Pedroia in 2008 to win the award. He's just 26, Dan. He had a .346 average. He hit 32 home runs. He stole 30 bases. What a player. In the National League, it's Christian Yelich, who beat out Nolan Arenado and Javi Baez to win the National League MVP. Two home runs shy of the Triple Crown, two home runs and one RBI shy of the Triple Crown. First Brewers player to win the NL MVP since Ryan Braun did it in 2011.
You're going to like this.
Oh, I can't wait for this one.
Noted ketchup enthusiast and Chiefs quarterback Patrick Mahomes has been offered a chance to win ketchup for life by Heinz, which is essentially, what, 7 bottles? Mahomes revealed he puts ketchup on his steak. Mahomes reaches 57 touchdowns this season. Heinz will give the 23-year-old ketchup for life. His 31 touchdowns so far this season. Started a lot of what do you put ketchup on discussions, and one of the ones in our newsroom was ketchup on mac and cheese.
Yeah, the Bare Naked Ladies sang about it, and if I had $1 million, they said they would buy the fancy Dijon ketchups if they... Producer Tim had never heard of people putting ketchup on mac and cheese in his life. This was a brand new thing to him today. He's 59 years old.
He was raised in the wilderness, don't forget.
Like everyone, to a man and a woman, mm-hmm, on the crew, absolutely bewildered by this news from producer Tim.
So do you eat your KD with ketchup?
No. But I have in the past, and I've heard of it. I've heard of people doing it. I personally like it.
I do.
I like KD right out of the pot, like as hot as...
Oh, yeah, it's got to be hot. I do if you put a little hot dogs in there, crunchy hot dogs.
Now, do you put ketchup on steak?
No. Bad steak, I use HP sauce.
Yes, right. Or Heinz. Doesn't Heinz make 57 sauce? Yeah, so
and
that's
legit
good.
Question, how many bottles is a lifetime supply of ketchup?
Well, if you're Patrick Mahomes, it's more than 7, clearly, if he's putting it on
steak. For me, I'm good 1 bottle a year.
I think I'm at 2, I think. Didn't Heinz send us some ketchup bottles with our faces on them?
I'm never opening that. I'm going to sell it for millions.
What's the best show in sports right now?
6'7", 285 pounds, Zion Williamson. Kevin Durant even called him a, quote, once-in-a-generation type athlete. But 3 games into a college career, and he already has his own top 10? Now that's impressive. And roll it.
It's actually not Zion Williamson. It's
No. Just give them a sec. All right, and here we go.
The top 10 is actually the top 10 airtime moments.
No!
How's your face?
I'm bleeding. Calgary Stampede, Bull Rider Zeb Lanham falls off the bull, lasted 4 seconds before the bull takes Lanham for a ride, sends him 15 feet into the air.
Slings him.
Oh, 15
feet. Yeah!
95, Packers, Bears. Remember this, Dan?
Oh, yeah.
Billy Ray Cyrus comes out of the crowd, catches the football, lands in the tunnel. 20 feet, baby. Billy Ray, achy, breaky heart.
April 2017, Cards, Jay, seventh inning. Chris Coughlin leaps over Yadi Molina, touches home in the process.
That was the top play of 2017 in the majors. April 2009, Talladega Super Speedway, Carl Edwards leading final lap, car spins, airborne, debris everywhere, very scary.
Oh, man.
You worry about the fans, of course, but they were okay, and Carl Edwards, as you can see, walked away.
2007, Dominic Hasek. Oh, boy. Just sends Marion Gaborik head over heels.
88 NBA Slam Dunk Contest. This is the origin of the Jumpman logo. And it's always better in slow-mo. The tongue is out. Jordan is skinny. He's got hair. Christmas Eve 2011. Jerome Simpson. It just makes me smile, this play. As opposed to the next play, which makes me scream.
Oh, yeah. Jake Brown. Oh, no.
What's he thinking right there?
Oh!
Oh, man, that was
fell 45 feet.
Oh, gosh.
That's a 5-story building.
His shoes. Did you
suffered
see
a dozen injuries.
Look at the shoes. But he walks away.
Oh, man, that's terrifying.
How's that face doing?
It's okay.
When we come back, we'll update you on the status of Dan's bloody face. It's the worst play of the day, and as predicted, it is Richard Bachman.
Antoine Roussel had a hold of his left leg. Here's a steal.
Author of The Running Man.
Koivu.
Who gives it away to Mikko Koivu. Not a great night for Stephen King.
Highlight of the night. He can get almost the same. It would have been the same thing. Except he came back and stopped it. Kincaid was trying for an empty net goal.
It didn't go. Kincaid was trying
to he's now got three shutouts on the year for the Devils. He's having a little chuckle.
Seems like a good guy.
You blew it. We pointed our errors. It's an alt-J edition. You pronounce Jason Zucker's last name as Zucker.
Nope, that's right. Whoever said that is wrong.
Jay said the Warriors were hosting Houston. They were, in fact, on the road facing the Rockets.
That's on me.
Jay started throwing to Durant post when we didn't have any Durant clips for our show.
It was in my script.
And you said the Tide Cats won 3 out of 3 matchup against the Red Blacks this season during the promo when, in fact, it was the Red Blacks who swept the season series.
That's definitely on me. Very quickly, we also had an awkward bro greeting. Haven't had one of these in a while. This is before the show, Dan. Let's watch this high five. This is how high fives work. I put up the hand. Just put up your note cards.
Well, the reason I did that, I would have had to like drop the cards and I'm like, that's this.
Looks like your face has stopped bleeding though.
Thanks for looking up. And let's bring our, after all that waiting.
at least it's not me this time.
While you're doing that, I had a shiver. That means a ghost passed through me, right?
Oh yeah, the ghost of Off the Record.
One, two, check, one, right, two, can you hear us?
But you know what, right now, toilet time.
What?
The question is Philly now the team to beat in the NBA's Eastern Conference? Better than Boston, better than Bucks, blah, 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 blah. Let me try that again.